Hello everyone, good evening. I'm Shreya Dhondial. A wrap of all the day's top stories over the next 30 minutes. We are starting with the big developments from Uttar Pradesh, where the death of a seer, one of India's most prominent, has sent shockwaves and spurred speculation. It's a death that is shrouded in mystery. Reports of Mahant Narendra Giri's alleged suicide at the Bangambari Mutt in Uttar Pradesh's Prayagraj yesterday evening has come as a big shock. After all, Narendra Giri was no simple Mahant. He was also the president of the All India Akhada Parishad, a body that comprises 13 recognized akhadas of the Hindu tradition. His flamboyant Shishya, with whom he had had a fallout, Anand Giri, was named in the suicide note he has left behind. Anand Giri is now under arrest. But as investigations gain pace, the suicide theory is coming under question. The late Hanumanji in Allahabad. Devotees from across India come to the banks of the Ganga to bow their head before the monkey god. On Monday afternoon, as devotees thronged the temple premises, little did anyone know that the head of the mutt to which this temple belongs had locked himself up in his room and hung himself to death. Narendra Giri, the Mahant of the Bangambari Mutt, a man who was also the head of the powerful Akhada Parishad, had ended his life in his own mutt. The shockwaves intensified when Anand Giri, Narendra Giri's high-profile disciple, was first detained and then finally arrested.
Maharaj jo hai rassi pe fande pe latak gaye hain. Maine pucha kahan hai Maharaj, to kahe ki wo jaldi hum logon ne kaat ke unko utar diya hai. Yahan hum log jab aaye to dekhe ki Maharaj ko zameen pe lete hue the.
It is this 15-page suicide note that has raised doubts about the police's suicide theory. The suicide note named Anand Giri along with two others. Narendra Giri in the suicide note allegedly says that he was under severe mental pressure because of these three, especially Anand Giri, and that he was being blackmailed for a video. He also claimed in the suicide note that he was driven to the edge because Anand Giri for the last 2 days was threatening to make a picture of him with a woman go viral. Anand Giri came out and made an equally sensational claim. Narendra Giri could hardly even sign his name, he said. Then how was it possible for him to write a 15-page suicide note that also doubles up as a will? Anand, who was thrown out of the mutt early this year after differences with Narendra Giri, says he's being framed.
हमारे गुरुजी की हत्या हुई है. ये बहुत बड़ा साजिश है. षड्यंत्र के तहत सबसे पहले मुझे उनसे अलग किया गया और आज उनको मार दिया गया है और मेरा नाम डाल करके मुझे भी खत्म करने की साजिश की जा रही है. मैं आला अधिकारियों से, योगी सरकार से हाथ जोड़ के प्रार्थना करता हूँ कि इसकी निष्पक्ष जांच हो. जांच में जो भी दोषी उसे दंड मिले और अगर मेरे प्रति किसी प्रकार की जांच प्रदेश सरकार चाहती है तो मैं हर प्रकार से तैयार हूँ. जाँच में सहयोग करूँगा. ये षड्यंत्र है. उनको फंसाया गया है, मारा गया है, उनकी हत्या हुई है. वो मरे नहीं हैं. जिस व्यक्ति ने अपने पूरे जीवन काल में, मैं 25 साल उनके साथ रहा हूँ, उन्होंने कभी एक लेटर नहीं लिखा, वो 5-6 पेज का सुसाइड नोट कैसे लिख सकते हैं,
ये विषय. आपका नाम आ रहा है,
निश्चित तौर पे नाम आया है, लेकिन ये हत्या है, साजिश के तहत नाम डाला गया है. मैं इसकी निष्पक्ष जाँच चाहता हूँ.
As the UP police conducts a post-mortem and forensic examination of the letter to determine who wrote the suicide note, the death at the ashram is already brewing a political storm. Akhilesh Yadav, the former chief minister of Uttar Pradesh, has pointed fingers at the Yogi Adityanath government. Yogi says, don't sensationalize a sensitive matter.
बार-बार सभा का नाम ले रही हैं. सरकार किसकी है? अगर कोई परेशानी थी, sitting judge जब इसकी जांच करेंगे तो वो सब सच्चाई बाहर आ जाएगी.
अनावश्यक बयानबाजी से बचें. जो भी इसके लिए जिम्मेदार होगा उसको कानून के दायरे में ला करके कड़ी से कड़ी सजा भी दिलाई जाएगी.
Mutts and akhadas command a huge following in the Hindu ecosystem and sit on large properties, cash and gold. Was Narendra Giri's death somehow linked to the wealth to which he stood guard as a custodian?
Narendgiri had good relations with politicians cutting across the party lines. Akhilesh Yadav's demand seeking a probe by the sitting judge of High Court hints of opposition's doubt over the suicide theory and the fact that how the death can become an issue of larger political implications in the state headed by a yogi. Pranshu Mishra in Lucknow for CNN News 18.
Let me go straight across to Pranshu Mishra, who's tracking the story for us from Lucknow. Pranshu, the simple question is, if this question, pertinent question on whether this was a suicide or a murder, needs to be settled, then first thing you need is a post-mortem, and then you need a forensic investigation of the suicide note. I believe 24 hours on, it's been more than 24 hours actually, and a post-mortem on the body of the Mahant has still not been conducted?
That's right, Shreyan. It will be done only after 10 a.m. tomorrow morning. The authorities say that since, you know, Akhada Parishad has decided that cremation should take place day before, day after tomorrow, that is on 23rd. Therefore, you know, post-mortem should not be too early. Otherwise, it will be difficult to, you know, sustain the mortal remains. So that's the reason why they are planning the post-mortem tomorrow afternoon. But yes, there has been a significant delay. And, you know, this could be a cause of concern that whether in a suspicious case of death, post-mortem taking place so late, whether, you know, it is feasible or does it, you know, tends to lose vital evidences, for example, the time of death, or maybe, you know, some other related aspects. But that is one aspect. The second aspect, of course, is that, you know, this case has also reached High Court, and today a PIL has been filed. What we are expecting is that maybe tomorrow High Court would be taking up this PIL. So it will be interesting to see how High Court also treats this case and whether High Court finds it fit to initiate some other inquiry or, you know, to just wait for UP police to come out with a detailed report which says that forensic investigation is already the part of process. It is going on. More details are being collected and the post-mortem report will add further clarity to it.
Pranshu, the central theme that is now emerging as far as this death is concerned, we still don't know if it's a murder or suicide. The initial assessment was that it is a suicide. Is the role of Anand Giri? Is the police saying anything about the fact that possibly the Mahant was being blackmailed by Anand Giri over a picture with a woman?
You know, now since this thing has been pointed out very clearly, and we have that letter where this excerpt we have read that how, you know, Naren Giri felt that some mock picture of him might be used to blackmail him. So I think the police has got the line for investigation. They are quizzing Anand Giri on this particular aspect, that what intimidating material did he have against Naren Giri to blackmail him and lead him to such a tragic decision, if actually it was a case of suicide. So line of investigation is clear, and I think the post-interrogation, something will come out. But as of now, those details, those leads have not been shared with us.
We leave it there for the moment. Thank you very much, Pranshu, for joining us from Lucknow. Meanwhile, in Delhi, AIMIM chief Asaduddin Oasi's home was vandalized earlier today. Five suspects have been detained. Oasi hit out at the centre saying that if an MP's home can be attacked, then one can imagine the state of the country. A member of the Hindu Sena has claimed responsibility for this attack. He said that Oasi's house was vandalized to teach him a lesson for speaking ill about Hindus during his rallies.
यही तो radicalized हो चुके हैं लोग और इनके radicalization की जिम्मेदारी बीजेपी सरकार पर आती है तो यही तो हम बता रहे हैं कि एक सांसद के घर पर अगर इस तरह हमला होगा तो क्या मैसेज जा रहा है पूरे देश में पूरे दुनिया में
अच्छा यहां पर आप जो आए थे मुलाकात
हां हां मिलने आए भाई यूपी के बहुत बड़े नेता हैं शिवपाल यादव साहब हम उनसे मिलने आए बात करने आए
मैं ललित कुमार हिंदू सेना प्रदेश अध्यक्ष आज हम इस जिहादी असदुद्दीन ओवैसी के घर आए हैं इसे सबक सिखाने क्योंकि वो हर कार्यक्रम में हर रैली में और हर भाषण में हिंदुओं को गलत कहता है हिंदू देवी देवताओं को गलत कहता है उसका भाई भी कहता है 15 मिनट के लिए पुलिस हटा लो हिंदुओं का सर्विनाश कर देंगे वो अकेला खड़ा होकर जब 100 करोड़ को धमकी दे सकता है तो हम 6-7 मिलकर हमारे साथी हैं दिखाइए साथी आए हैं हमारे और हम उसको आज सबक सिखाने आए हैं आपके अगली वीडियो ये सबक सिखाने वाले होगी जय श्री राम
In news from the world of defense, Air Marshal V.R. Chaudhary has been selected as the next chief of the Indian Air Force. Air Marshal Chaudhary is presently the Vice Chief of Air Staff. He will be taking over after the retirement of Air Chief Marshal R.K.S. Bhaduria, which happens on 30th of September. He served 39 years in the Indian Air Force as a pilot, has about 3,900 flying hours under his belt. The center has told the Supreme Court that the NDA can start the induction of women in 2022. The NDA will be ready to welcome its first batch of women cadets in 2023 after they sit for the entrance exam in May next year. The problem will be of logistics, of trying to arrange separate living quarters for women cadets in the NDA. Extra squadrons, as we speak, are being constructed for the same. The Indian Army has paid tribute to two pilots who lost their lives in a helicopter crash today. The helicopter crashed during a sortie in the Patnitop area of Jammu and Kashmir. Major Rohit Kumar and Major Amnuj Rajput were rushed to the hospital by locals, where they succumbed to their injuries. Security forces are hunting for 4 to 6 terrorists who attempted to infiltrate into the Uri sector. If successful, this will be the biggest infiltration attempt by terrorists from across the line of control in recent years. Internet and phone services were suspended to aid the combing operations, which continue as we speak.
There's been an operation which has been ongoing for last about 24 hours in Uri, in which we felt that there's an infiltration attempt which has been made. We are looking for them. Are they on this side, or they, after having made an attempt, they have gone back? That issue has not yet been clarified or verified on the ground. But however, I can assure you that we are quite alert. Our troops on the ground are totally alert, and we will ensure that minimal infiltration takes place whenever the attempt is made.
A massive consignment of nearly 3,000 kgs of heroin worth 21,000 crore rupees was seized from the Mundra port in Gujarat. Two Afghan nationals have been arrested. The Enforcement Directorate has now taken over as links to the Taliban and Afghanistan continue to emerge. The United Kingdom's new travel norms that do not recognize people vaccinated in India as fully vaccinated has led to a diplomatic firestorm. India's Foreign Secretary Harsh Shringla has warned of a reciprocal policy. External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar has asked the UK Foreign Secretary for an immediate resolution, as the UK announced that fully vaccinated Indians will have to undergo a mandatory 10-day quarantine upon landing, since the vaccines used in India, that is Covishield, Covaxin and Sputnik, are not approved in the UK.
The basic issue is that here is a vaccine, Covishield, which is a licensed product of a UK company. Non-recognition of Covishield is a discriminatory policy and does impact on those of our citizens travelling to the UK. Obviously, as we go along, we will have to see how it goes. But if we don't get satisfaction, we would be within our rights to impose reciprocal measures.
Argument which is being given by UK government is that we've gone through an ordeal, we've gone through terrible times, and there have been several COVID cases. We don't want to take a risk. You agree with that? You buy that?
Look, every government has every right not to take any risks that they don't want to take. That's entirely up to them. But the fact is that when people with this vaccine from other countries are being allowed in, and Indians are not, it reeks of double standards, to put it politely. I've been hesitating to use a word like racism, because I do believe that Britain is now a much more multicultural society. Their home minister and their finance minister are both of Indian origin, so it's difficult to use that word. But certainly the double standards are incomprehensible. And speaking for myself, I do find it rather offensive that a fully vaccinated Indian must quarantine for 10 days, whereas others, including Pakistanis and Bangladeshis, don't have to. So I don't see the logic of this. And I do believe I want no part of it. So I pulled out of events in London in the later part of October, because I don't see why, as an Indian, I have to be put through this. The thing is that the Brits were actually victims of the same policy by the Americans. That is that people from Britain were not being admitted to the US. And so they were smarting from that until the new American policy was announced yesterday. So in fact, the British know exactly what it feels like to be unjustly told that somehow you are less safe than the people in the country that you are traveling to. The Indian authorities, that is the foreign ministry, have been talking pretty strongly to the British. And the British are taking the line that it's just a question of working out the technical details that will permit them to reconsider their policy. So as of now, we are still not allowed. But if they can work out the technical steps that will satisfy them as to the authenticity of our certification, I think we should be able to move forward. But this is still a rather unfortunate situation. And I'll add one more thing, Pallavi, which is that in international relations, reciprocity is the name of the game. And so ultimately, the British will have to treat us the way they expect us to treat them. And I think that's fair on both sides.
And continuing to be with the story, CNBC TV 18 Shireen Bhan spoke to Serum Institute CEO Adar Poonawalla regarding this ongoing vaccine racism. This is what he said.
Adar, I want to now talk to you about what's happening globally with the vaccine-related travel restrictions. The UK overnight has announced that India will fall under the category of unvaccinated. They're not recognizing Covishield either, even though the WHO has approved Covishield. Now, what do you make of this? Because essentially, what you're producing is the AstraZeneca vaccine.
Yeah, so I think everybody knows it's identical. It's been proven. We've submitted that data to the EMA and the UK MHRA, despite what you hear, that it is identical. Now, they're reviewing it. I've had personally consultations with the regulators there, and they're going to get back to us very shortly. Let me answer this in two ways. You know, ever since a couple of months ago, 6 to 7 months ago, this talk about vaccine passports for travel has been a topic. I am really shocked and surprised to see why, and I'm not just talking to the UK and India relationship, I'm talking about all countries. Why have they not been able to come together? One standard QR code or some way to scan on your phone or other devices, one standard certificate. Let me just give you one even more ridiculous example to what is going on between India and UK at the moment. Even a vaccine like Pfizer or Moderna, if taken in the UAE, for example, or some of these other countries that you mentioned, is not recognized, even though it's made by the same company, same brand, in the UK and in other countries. So until all these countries agree to harmonize and accept each other's vaccination programs and certificates, there's nothing a manufacturer can do or any individual can do except raise my voice, which I have been doing, to the heads of the European Commission, WTO, WHO, and some of the leaders of these countries without naming names.